The skyline has changed so much since I was last here. I was here about 4 years ago, and I reckon half of these skyscrapers weren't there. It's crazy how much this place is changing.
G'day guys, Tills20 here and welcome back to Sichuan Province. This episode is all about expanding the city, and just about everything you see me do in this episode, I don't plan to keep. Everything here is temporary, it's just there as a placeholder so that we have the bulk of the city finished, so that the city always feels like a city, and then we can get into the detail and just focus on making the place just look awesome. But for the time being, I think it's really important to make the city feel like an actual place by turning it into a city, because at the moment it's just a bunch of roads and I want to change that ASAP. So this episode is really just me figuring out where I want everything to go, and then we can really start building. So I'm going to start this episode off a little bit different, and we're just going to look at the map and I'll talk about where I want different locations to sit. And obviously some things will change and, you know, be a little bit different as we work on the series, and I want your input as well as we work on this too, so nothing's set in stone. But I really wanted to have a good idea of where I want, or at least an idea of where I want things to go, and I want to be really upfront and just let you guys know that too, so I can get your opinions. So at the moment, all we really have are the roads, and these are the bulk of the highways. I can't see myself building any more highways, but these will be detailed later on, and I think they sit in a fairly realistic area. The heart of the city, the downtown, is going to sit in this location. We worked over here in the last episode where we built the interchange, and I would like there to be a little bit of industry sitting around here and in a couple of other locations on the map. We're going to have an airport, and it's going to sit up in this corner here where there is also going to be a port. So this is where quite a bit of the industry is going to sit in the city. There's also a power station I've placed down in this location, and that's also where I'm going to be placing a fair bit of industry as well. So industry is fairly out of the city, at least the main polluting industries, so like the incinerators and the power stations. Whereas there will still be a fair bit of warehouses in other locations. A bulk of where the industry is going to sit is going to be around here, which is also where the central station is going to be. So this will be the station that basically connects up with the greater region of this province and also to other locations. So quite a lot of people will be coming in and out of here. So naturally, a lot of the transit will be targeting this area. And I also plan to have the fast rail connected up to here too. Opposite the downtown would be the financial district, where I also plan to place quite a lot of larger buildings. It'd be quite a nice area around here, so I think there'll be quite a lot of more high residential areas. And the bulk of the residential districts will be like scattered around the city, so there'll be a fair bit of residents. And most people are going to live in high-rises, so at this stage, I just plan to build mostly high-rise apartments. As you can probably tell by the cinematics at the very beginning, so the real-life footage, like China is, like most of the population are in apartment blocks, so I plan to do very similar style of houses in Sichuan province. Again, don't have a name for the city. Please hit me up if you have any name suggestions. And also district names and suburbs. I really want this to feel like a city, and I would really like your input as well. I really don't want to just be running the whole show. And I also don't want it just to feel like another border town like my old series. With that series, I felt quite burnt out very quickly because I was really just focused on the detail work. So going into this project, I really want to focus more on expanding out the place like a real city, whereas Border Town was just pure detail work and pretty much just copying what El Paso looked like. this is such a different project, and yeah, I'm just really excited to expand it out in the way that I have in mind. What I am doing right now is I'm working on the downtown. Pretty much nothing you see me working on right now is going to be kept. In fact, all the skyline is going to change. The biggest building as well will change too. So if you've actually seen the teaser for this series, then you will notice that there is a different skyline. So yeah, don't expect anything of this to change. But don't expect any of this to stay the same. I did want to keep this though in the time lapse because I thought it might be interesting for you to see my thought process as I was going through it. So something that I was doing, because I had subscribed to so many different types of buildings, and pretty much any type of building that popped up on the workshop that was that was like an Asian building, I would just subscribe to it straight away. And it wasn't until I got in game I could actually test them out. So many buildings that I wanted to use were too tall, or they're too small, or the LOD didn't work very well, or it just didn't fit in with the colors. It all depended on like all those factors. It really needed to be the perfect building for it to work out. You know, I pretty much halved my asset collection when I did this process, because I would realize that some buildings weren't the right style and I'd have to just unsubscribe. So that was the process going into this. And yeah, like I said, none of that stays the same. What I'm doing now is working on the financial districts and figuring out what types of buildings I want here. Again, same process. The financial district is going to be very similar to the downtown in terms of it's going to be very planned, and there's going to be quite a lot of taller buildings. So I am planning for the financial districts to almost be like a second skyline. Not quite as tall, but still fairly prominent, and still have a fairly large skyline. And to be honest, most of this city is going to be fairly large. And like I said before, most of the population is going to sit in apartment blocks. So we're not really going to be doing any sort of like suburbs with a particular style of house. Most areas are going to be apartment blocks. And yeah, I mean, like noticing as well, like particularly when you're like traveling via train around China, you just go past a lot of the suburbs that sit on the fringes of the cities. They're really quite eerie the way that they're built, because they're all so uniformed, and they are like nothing's unique. They're all like just exactly the same. And there's just rows and rows of these apartment blocks with, I guess, like slight differences, but really there's not much different between them. It's really kind of interesting. And to be honest, it's going to make it fairly easy for me to develop up the population quite quickly, because there will just be areas where I can just completely copy and paste. Because, I mean, that's generally how it looks in some areas in China. There are apartment blocks that are just completely identical to one another. And a lot of these areas, pretty much all these apartment blocks have like very communal like playgrounds and spaces below them, because a lot of people will actually use these areas quite a lot. And that's another reason why I really love visiting China, is that people aren't just in their houses all the time. Like, I feel like in Australia, people do just spend most of their lives inside their houses. Whereas in China, people are out, you know, eating street food, or out in restaurants, or they're out in the parks, or they're out shopping. Everyone is out doing stuff. And when you're traveling and visiting a country, that's really nice, because it means you're just doing the same thing as everybody else. So I will be, this is like not a really good example of me building up these types of apartment blocks, because I am really just gonna fly through them and just build them really quickly. I will be spending a fair bit of time though developing up these particular suburbs with like these high-rise apartments. And yeah, I look forward to when I actually finally do that. By the way, I do plan to do a few mass builds in the like cycle of this series. This is like the first one, and then I do plan to do a few more, just to, you know, spend a bit of time expanding out and making sure that we really reaching some certain areas, so that it never, no area really feels unfinished. And there's like much work as I put into this episode. It, like, I do a fair bit of building in this episode, and it does take a fair bit of time. There's still areas that I'm like, I really wish I spent more time and plopped down some buildings. This area in particular. Something you saw me build just before was I built an area where a lot of the sewage is going to be pumped. I actually placed that in that location because it was actually traveling downstream, and I wanted the water to be more brown, because that is something that is so crazy about the water in Chongqing, is that the water is like a chocolatey brown. It almost feels like you're traveling in the like Amazon jungle or something like that, because the water is just so dirty and so churned up. And obviously, like, that's just mud being churned up in the currents below. Whereas, like, the water that I'm working with in City Skylines is like a beautiful blue, the sort of blue you'd imagine from the ocean. So it doesn't really work. So that was me trying to get the color to change, but I thought the sewage would then turn all the water brown. It didn't, and it didn't really work. However, you might have noticed from the cinematic intro from the last episode, I get the water to a very chocolatey, very awesome brown color. And that was all done via the help of Bad Idea. Again, coming to my rescue, I actually asked him, how can I get my water to be a chocolate brown? And he said that if you just go into the, and it's a very easy fix, if you just go into the map theme editor, which is within the game, you can alter the different, you can alter the colors of the water. And I just changed the color to brown and then saved it, and yeah, it just looks so good. It changes everything. It's an absolute game changer for me. And this episode, the water is still blue. Next episode, the water's, I think, still blue. But then I think about episode 5, the water will be just beautifully brown. So look forward to that. Yeah, as you can see, I'm still playing around these buildings, still trying to figure out what the skyline's going to look like. I'm playing with a whole bunch of very iconic buildings, a lot of iconic buildings from Hong Kong. So there's the Bank of China that I placed down, which, again, beautiful building, but I think it's just too iconic. It's something that you just immediately go, that's like from Hong Kong. Whereas I really didn't want that. I wanted there to be more unique buildings within this city. I also do place down, I think it's called the Siam Tower. I could be wrong. I'm not going to pause it and research. I'm just going to leave it at that. I believe you can see it in this frame right now. I really, really like where it sits, but I would actually really like your opinion too. So let me know, is that too iconic? I believe it's in Guangzhou, that tower, and it is still quite an iconic tower, but I think it works in this city. But do let me know. I would like your opinion. Now I'm starting to work on like a mass build of apartment blocks. And I'm really just trying to develop up the skyline, really trying to build something of a population, so that when we start working on areas and I press play and the simulation starts running, we're seeing the right amount of cars driving through, we're seeing people using their transport. And when we do come back to this area and I demolish all this and build something in more detail, it's not going to change a hell of a lot, because basically that population has always been there. And that's sort of the idea behind this build right now. I really just want to build up the population so we can really see the city come to life. And I'm doing a real mix of buildings. I didn't want it just to be all the same style of modern apartment block. I am mixing it with like bulks of more older style apartment blocks, and some of the taller ones, some of the shorter ones. It's a real mix. You can also see me placing down a fair bit of schools and hospitals and services, because I want this city to function. I don't want just to be placing down buildings for the hell of it. I do want this to be a city that is functioning the way that a city should function. So for every block of apartment blocks, apartment buildings, I am also placing down a fair decent amount of services, so that that's all being taken care of. So that's taken a fair bit of time to do. A lot of what I am doing in this episode, I am actually just not showing it. I've deleted a fair bit of footage so that you guys don't have to watch me place down a lot of the same things. You're seeing a lot of the same building also placed down, but again, that is just the nature of like a Chinese city. A lot of the same building is actually just built in very much of the same fashion, which makes my life very much easier when it comes to building a Chinese city and city skylines, because I have no worries just placing down the same building over and over again. But it looks great when you look at it from afar, which is what you're mostly going to be seeing. You're mostly going to be seeing these places at afar. And in saying that, this is probably like the closest you're going to be to this area. And I'm going to keep most of this off camera. Not off camera, but in the far distance. So when we start building in some more detailed areas and working on some places that I, you know, put a lot of thought and effort into how it looks, you'll see all this in the backdrop. I don't really plan for you to really be looking at what I'm doing any closer than what you are seeing right now. I plan for most of the time you see in this area, it's going to be in the far distance, or I'm developing it again and demolishing most of what you see, and then I'm just rebuilding it in a far better style. Speaking of style, the color correction of what you're watching right now is not going to stay this way. I change it a fair bit. Actually, the next episode is probably the worst example of how it should be. I play with the settings way too much and I really don't like it. This episode's fairly similar. I don't like the way that looks right now. But the episode, I think, say episode 5, it's just beautiful. It's exactly how it should be. It's a perfect mix of brightness and contrast, and it's just vivid and very realistic. It's something that I'm really quite proud of. I'll be sharing you, by the way, all those settings so that you can get a good example of what it looks like when I work really hard at trying to get the right color correction. Also, I'm still mucking around with the Foggit mods that Bad Idea created for me. Again, I love it. I think it looks awesome, but without using Cubase mods and having beautiful clouds in the skies, I don't know how useful it is. It creates really great smog effects, but it also it just changes the way that I want my color correction to look. So there's got to be like a really good balance. I still haven't figured it out yet. Hopefully the Daylight Classic mod can be fixed, or not fixed, but sorted out so that it is a bit more useful when it comes to, you know, creations like this. Something you saw me build as well was a theme park. Again, I just whipped it together. I don't plan it to stay like that, but I do plan for a theme park to sit in that location. I also would like to create more dramatic differences in the landscape. So at the moment, like, we are looking at quite large gradients in terms of the landscape, but I would like it to be a bit larger. Obviously, it's trickier to use, but I think the effects is just awesome. So I'm going to be working on making it more hilly, more mountainous. And even that interchange that I built in the last episode, I ended up pushing that up almost doubling the size of that mountain that interchange is sitting on. Working on more blocks of apartments. Something that I'm also doing, which is a technique I'm going to use quite a bit of, is I'm using the ground textures to just change a little bit of the ground so that it just looks a little bit more developed on, and it gives it an illusion of either farmland or industrial areas. So I am just like making blocks and then just covering it in a different type of ground texture, and it works quite nicely. I'm actually quite surprised at how good it works. So I'll be doing that in a fair few locations, and probably even like past the ridges of the mountains, I will end up using that effect to create some farmlands. Something else I'm doing is I'm using the warehouses that came with the Industries DLC and just placing them down in bulk in certain areas, because they take up a fair bit of area and they look quite good. So they're really lovely looking assets. Even though they're vanilla and we're obviously going for a very high detailed modified type of build, they work really nicely just to bulk up areas. And switching them to generic usage, you know, from basically industries, generic industry, industrial areas. That's what I'm trying to say. That, yeah, they work really well in terms of like getting industry and goods around the city. So I'm placing them down a fair bit in this city. There are a fair bit of warehouses in China, so it actually works quite nicely with the whole theme. And unfortunately, I have to place them pretty close to these apartment blocks. But I've also placed a fair bit of parks and services and stuff, so there's a good balance between some noisy warehouses and some areas that are a bit more decent. And like I said, I am also trying to make sure that these residents stay fairly happy, because even though I am pushing up the population a fair bit, if I don't make them happy, then they will leave, and I really don't want that. And on that, like, when I did Border Town, again, back with Border Town, but when I created Border Town, because I was just mostly focusing on detail, I didn't really care about what the residents were doing. I didn't really care if there were roads going in the wrong, like, in place to places that didn't exist or whatever. I didn't really care too much about how that city really functioned. And I really got burnt out quite quickly. Whereas in this series, even though I'm going for obviously a very highly detailed and very modified game, the gameplay for me is getting people around the city and also making the city function. I don't want it to just be almost like a canvas and me painting a city onto it. I don't want it just to look like a city. I want it to feel and act like a city. And I don't want that to be compromised by me trying to detail areas or compromised by me trying to make sure that the right neighborhoods and the right locations. I always just want it to be something that functions. So placing down schools and hospitals and police stations and parks and making sure that people are, you know, still happy with their location in the city, it's still very important. So I think that the way that I play the game is I still need to see some sort of functionality. There still needs to be like a purpose to this. I think that creating something that's beautiful and eye candy isn't really enough for my gameplay experience. I always need something to be, it always has to feel like a real place. And if it's not functioning, if everything's complaining, if there's no power, if there's no water, then that's not good enough for what I want to do. Last little bit of this episode is me building the, what's my call it? It's called an airport, $2.20. That's what it's called. Using the vanilla one. I know, guys. I know you stop freaking out. I am just placing down the airport again as a placeholder. When I do build the airport, it's going to be custom and there will be a fair bit of detail and thought process going into this build. I'm actually excited to build this airport, even though I'm fairly, I've done my fair few airports in this game. But for the time being, I thought I'd place down a cargo airport and also an international one, just so I can see planes getting in, and I can also treat this area as an area that is already getting a fair few people coming in and out of the city. This road as well will be fairly large, and will also make sure that it can support a fair few people getting in and out. Plus, there's going to be the port around here too, which means there will be like a lot of transit coming in and out. This is also where the monorail is going to come to, and potentially even the metro line will also hit this area up, and there'll be a fair few cargo trains too. There's so much to do in this series. It might sort of seem like it's overwhelming and it might seem like it's undoable, but I have really been thinking about the ways that I'm going to tackle this project, and already, I think you can already see that the things that I'm doing in this series from the get-go, I mean, we're up to episode 3 and we're sitting on 50,000 people already sitting in this city. I know it says 42,000, but that ends up going up to 50,000 by the end of the episode. But yeah, I do really look forward to seeing that number crank up to about 100,000. At least that's the plan. At this stage, I think 100,000 would be a pretty good number to sit on. I've never reached a city to that level. Not even Springwood reached to that level, but we'll have to wait and see how we go. But guys, that is it for this episode. I hope it's been a good one for you. Next episode, well actually next week, we're going to be back in Marble Mountain, finishing up the light rail system, and then Sichuan Province will be back the week after. Finally doing some detail work, which, again, super happy with how it turns out. But guys, that is it. Hope you've enjoyed it. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.